I remember his mom, I remember his dad. He's been singing for a long, long time, and he's still young. He's a husband, a father, and he's still young. But I want y'all to give it up for none other than Minister Corey Teague of Patterson, New Orleans.
Right, praise God, everybody. So I want to do a song, a couple songs for you, but you know, this is what, 20 years now?
22.
22? All right, so then that's the amount of time we know each other.
Yep.
We met each other 22 years ago at the Patterson Library, you know? And he came to me and he said that he wanted to have a gospel service to celebrate his birthday.
All right.
And the very first one was at
Macedonia.
Yeah, Macedonia Sounds of Praise on Market Street.
Yep.
Mother Moore. That was the very first place he had his very first program.
That's right.
And so we've been rocking every year since then. Yeah, every year since the very beginning, since day one. Yeah, so I remember we started out in the basement of his apartment. That's what we started working on. The office was in the basement. His chair was a crate behind a cardboard box. That was his office back in the day. That's how we started. And I remember the day that we went to a church service. I don't know if it was up here in South Jersey. And they were singing, what kind of church this is, but they were singing the, you know, the congregational version. And we were riding back. He said, you know, we got to do something to make the young people get into that song.
That's right, Corey.
So he started developing the hip-hop version, the gospel hip-hop version. I remember how it all started. The other song, Do You Love My Jesus, that was a song that was Teron Ramsey, but it was an older version. He said, we got to bring it down where our young people can groove to it.
Mm-hmm.
And he formed that. And he said, I Don't Want to Go to Hell. That was an old, you know, Sounds of Praise song. And he ramped it up. The point I'm making is he's an artist.
Yes, he is.
But you can take something and turn it into something totally different where the public can still hear it and accept it. That's an artist.
That's right.
So he takes those songs, and he's been doing that for years, ever since I've known
him. That's right.
I'm just going to tell y'all, he's legit, ever since from day one. Whenever Elvis, or Church Boy, I remember him when he was Elvis, before he even put Church Man there. Because I remember we had a big argument. I'm like, Elvis, that's too long to put in the middle of your name there. He said, I should call myself Elvis Church Boy Durham. I'm like, whoa, that's too long, brother. So he said, okay, I'm just going to say Church Boy then.
Right.
So I remember all that. When he was formulating his image, when he was getting everything together, I remember when he the first day he said, we're going to call it Christian Brothers. I remember the whole shebang from the Jump Street. So seeing him where he is, from then to now, I'm truly encouraged by that he never gave up. He's still going.
Hallelujah.
All right, I'm just going to do a congregational song, a couple of congregational songs, so I can get out of your hair. Well, God is a good God. Thank you.
has a soul now.
Yay!
Up on the ocean, and it's moving. It's
moving.
If you're cold now, and you need help, you will surely.
Thank you.
Excellent vocalist.
Yes,
excellent.
Sir.
He competed, I remember one time,
yes,
McDonald's Gospel Fest on, when they had the tryouts on Broadway here in Patterson.
Yes.
Beautiful, beautiful voice. So if you don't know him, get to know him. I'm sorry.